Ladies and gentlemen, for a few moments today, I'd like to bring your attention to the Word of God, the Bible. The Bible and all its love and strength. The Bible, the Word of God, that can put that love and strength in our heart. The Bible which shows us the way to Jesus. The Bible which shows us how to deal with our sin. Ladies and gentlemen, here today for a few moments in the town of Wicklow in the Republic of Ireland, I'd like to draw your attention of man's need of God. How that the Bible said, all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. That you and that I, that each and every one have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. You and I, we don't need to argue with the Bible. This is not my thought or my philosophy. This is that which is recorded in the Bible. This is that which sits in your church, in your home, your Bible. And I'm pleased today to say that God wants the people to return to reading their Bible. This is the good thing, that we can have a Bible that men were butchered for, hung, drawn, and quartered, that we might have a copy of the Bible in English, that we might be able to read the Bible for ourselves. Ladies and gentlemen, then, for a few moments today, I want to speak to you of the importance of the Bible, the Holy Writ of God from heaven, how that Jesus, God's only begotten Son, came down the stairway from heaven to planet Earth and give His life for the people. Give His life that whosoever would believe on Him should not perish but have everlasting life. My friend, you can have this everlasting life. When you die, you can have the best assurance that you will go to heaven. The Bible is clear. It is heaven or hell. That's in your Bible as well as mine. It's heaven or hell. Now, I didn't make it that way, but God did. God said it was that way, but in His love, He has made the provision that whosoever will believe on Him should not perish and go to this terrible place called hell. In hell there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. In hell there will be wailing and crying because people have rejected the provision of God. The provision of God. People have rejected the provision of God. Have you rejected the provision of God? The provision of God is Jesus Christ, the only provision. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. He has not given two or three ways, He's given one way. And that one way is Jesus. How Jesus loved the people and died on Calvary's cross. That whosoever, now my friend, you're included in the whosoever. And I call that good news today. I call that wonderful news. That we can be included in the whosoever. How that Jesus gave His life that whosoever will believe on Him should not perish but have everlasting life. Think about it. The gift of everlasting life. And yes, my friend, it is a gift. It is a free gift according to the Word of God. How did Jesus give this free gift through the shedding of His blood on Calvary's cross? Myself and these workers today, giving out these tracts and bringing this good news to you, we have been saved from our sin. If we can help you, you can receive a tract today, and in that tract, you will find the way to salvation. It's a small portion. This tract here is a small portion of the Word of God. Yes, ma'am. Yes, sir. This truck is a small portion of what's contained in this Bible. If you receive this truck, you will receive a portion of the Word of God. And in that portion of truck, you can read the Word of God for yourself. You can look and find, you can study and pray and ask God, what about me? What about my sin? For the Bible said, all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. What about you there? What about your sin? You someday will have to deal with the sin question. I've had to deal with my sin question. What will you do about your sin question? Each have sinned, each have come short of the glory of God. God has given the provision on Calvary's cross, His Son Jesus. The provision, Jesus Christ. The price, Calvary cross. The purpose, the salvation of mankind. Hallelujah! The purpose, the salvation of mankind. That Christ died for the people's sins. That whosoever would believe on Him should not perish, but find everlasting life.